PewDiePie.
Are you the left one?
I like it.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Very nice to have you on the show.
Thank you.
Sorry
about the Norway thing. It's just, you weren't supposed to know about that.
Well, we found it, you know. Thing is that we could speak Swedish, but we're out of politeness, we speak
of
English.
Of course, yeah.
And you
are
actually...
good. Good, bro.
do you speak?
That's all I speak, you know. That's all. The rest gets into foul language, so let's keep it in English.
And you actually live here in England.
That's right. Yeah. So I'm actually more accustomed to English at this point. So it's all good.
What we saw here now was clips from your YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. And you must explain. Please explain. You play computer games.
Pretty much, yeah. Any video game there is that is, I like the stupid and silly games that no one ever plays. I like to find these ridiculous games and then turn that no one would ever play them because they're so bad. But then I'll commentate over them and make it into comedy somehow.
So what you do is that you film yourself while you're playing.
Pretty much, yeah. It's kind of a ridiculous thing. I just commentate while I play video games.
As a viewer, I can follow both the video game and the
exactly.
You're watching it.
You get the gameplay, and then you have my head in the corner, where I'm screaming pretty much.
Yes, because you have strong reactions.
Exactly. Right? Yes.
And that's what's the fun, you know.
I think
watching
so. Yeah.
You, yeah.
Yeah. And, it's crazy.
It is actually. Yeah. I have been watching it now. Yeah.
Well, and I know the whole concept seems weird to us because we're old, but I rang up my children, my 13-year-old and my 11-year-old.
Yeah.
And went, I'm just about to be on a show with PewDiePie, and they went, "Oh my god!" And I went, "Do you know anything about
that's
PewDiePie?"
The thing.
They immediately went, "Yes, he's from Sweden, but he lives in Brighton now. He's a gamer. He's on YouTube. He has 34 million viewers. It's the most that anybody." He has. His girlfriend is a gamer also, and he recently turned off the comments section on his tube, and that's been very controversial. I was like, how do you know this much about it? When
yeah,
I get to do
awesome.
Your homework about Roman history, you don't know anything. They knew everything about you. It was incredible.
And thank you. Now we have like 10 minutes to talk about what? I mean, you're just... You know, if I could talk as fast as you can, this show would be over in like 15 minutes.
We could go in depth now.
let's go in depth. But, because this is as of now, it's your day job.
Pretty much, yeah.
How is a day at work for you? What do you do?
It's so hard. I play video games all day. People don't understand the struggle.
When you started out, were you one of those kids that were obsessed with the video games?
Yeah, definitely.
You were?
Of course, obviously. I think you can kind of tell.
You went to school as well.
Of course,
you?
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
No, but
people not go to
yeah.
School.
Well, she did.
Oh, I'm sorry. I dropped out as well, so I feel you. Don't worry.
You dropped out as well.
Well, university, yeah.
Okay.
You know, my parents weren't too happy about me dropping out of school, so they weren't really like, okay, we'll support you dropping out of school to play video games. I don't think many parents would do that, so nothing bad on them. But so they were like, you have to get a job, and I was like, all right, I'll get a job. So I took the first bet, and I worked at, what's it called? Korvkiosk. hot dog stand. There you go, yeah. Sorry.
You were selling hot dogs?
I sold hot dogs, yeah, and it was... right next to my old university as well. So like a lot of friends that I don't really know that well just all of a sudden meet me there and like,
students.
Wait, you dropped out of school to sell hot dogs? It's kind of awkward, but luckily it worked out, so.
It worked out indeed.
Yeah.
It's now a huge success, the biggest success on YouTube.
And
in the
I
world.
Made some great hot dogs, so like, let's not talk about it.
You have, as far as I know, this from ads. You earn money from ads.
Exactly. Yeah.
And it was like last year I could read it was almost 30 million kroner.
Which currency? Are we? Oh, what?
Kroner, the Swedish kroner.
Oh, kroner. Yeah.
Am I in...
I don't like to talk
no,
about
no,
that.
No, no, okay, but... So,
yeah. Well, what's that in pounds or
yeah.
euros?
What's that in pounds?
I would say £3 million.
Is that before almost. Or after taxes?
Yeah.
Before. But that's amazing.
For playing video games, yeah, it's probably more than I deserve.
That's what you should have done, you know?
Many things I should have done.
Hey, it's never too late.
But that's pretty cool. Again, calling your passion your job and
yeah,
make a living of it.
Exactly.
I mean, that's wonderful.
I don't know, but we had an incident before you were coming here today.
Oh, what
because,
happened?
Yes, well, the editor that you talked to, that you worked with, preparing this interview, he went home to his family and he was telling his kids that, that we were having you on the show. And his six-year-old didn't know who you were, so he showed him a few clips. And today, we got here in London, we got a telephone in the middle of a meeting from his school, from the kids' school, that he was using the F-word in class.
Where did he get that from? I have no idea. Must be from your show.
And if you I mean, you've got so many. You've got 30 million, more than 30 million kids watching.
Yeah.
What do you think about that? Do you feel that responsibility?
Definitely. Yeah. I think the swearing is definitely something I feel generally bad about hearing that because that's not something I want to do. But I like to just make the videos as the way I like them. I like to try not. Obviously, some stuff that I say will affect a lot of people, but I still try to just do what I want to do. And if people want to watch it, they can watch it, kind of.
Well,
that's a vague answer, I'm sorry.
Would it sometimes be an advantage if you had a smaller audience? Can you sometimes envy people with a smaller audience?
Yeah, well, I guess very recently, there's anytime kind of I like you said about I turned off the comments and that's been very controversial.
why did you do that?
Well, it's a long story. There's just a lot of spam and stuff, so I got bothered by it. But all this sudden, there's all this attention for me, and all I really intended to do was to play video games. So it's kind of insane that I have this influence that I never really intended for and never really sought out. But I also see it as kind of an opportunity to use it for good, and I've done a couple of charity work where I involve my fans and they can donate, and it's I like to see that as something positive at least. And I can see the comments when they donated, and it's like, oh, I donated for the first time, and I think that's a good thing to teach younger children at least. So in some aspect, I'm aware of it, but yeah, the swearing, I'll try and tone it down.
Thank you. That's what I wanted
Sorry.
To say. There is another YouTube star called Cutie Pie.
Oh yeah, I'm
and
who's that?
She's your girlfriend.
Yeah.
How
Cutie
did you,
Pie.
Cutie
That's
Pie.
Very
yes.
nice.
Cutie
name.
Pie and Cutie Pie.
Yeah, now you're
were
interested.
Made to
yes.
be together.
How did it happen? I don't know.
How did it happen? How did you two meet?
Oh,
how
did
you... online.
There you go. Yeah. Why are you laughing?
Sorry.
I'm
so you.
No, it's all right.
You met online.
We did meet online. And, I know it is kind of a weird thing, but I think most of my friends who do YouTube, they met all their girlfriends online, so it's becoming more normal. I think very early when I started my videos, I just had a couple followers. One of our friends in Italy, she's from Italy, she sent an email to her with my video in it saying, look at this idiot playing video games. So apparently she liked that idiot, but... So we started talking, and I went to visit her in Italy.
You went not knowing her at all, online.
Yeah, it's I don't know what I was thinking, but her parents didn't speak any English, and it was just super weird. But it worked out, yeah.
So now you live together?
Yeah, we live here in Brighton.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Very romantic. Are you romantic?
I can be,
obviously,
but it's not good for my internet persona. You know, I'm a nerd. I can't be that. No, of course I no.
We were speaking about a tennis career, and that is a limited career. You can't go on forever, obviously. As you can. What about your career? Where are you when you're like?
Are you trying to say I can't 70? Do YouTube forever?
I don't know. I know.
Well, because you can.
How would I know? Probably. Yeah.
I don't really see myself doing it forever, but I say as long as it's fun, I'll do it. I'm sure. It opens up a lot of possibilities, I think. But
is this like pop music? They all said back in the 60s and 70s that they would quit after 40, and now they're all 70 and 80.
Well, I think this is. I think this is the new equivalent of like tech and online stuff, and particularly the YouTube stuff is the equivalent of what was happening with rock and roll in the 50s and 60s. It's just what the young people are doing. The old people don't understand it. Going, how are you earning money from this? It'll all be over in 2 years. I don't get how it works. This seems bizarre. Yeah. But this is where, you know, kids can, and particularly now, sort of the money's gone out of the music industry. It's very difficult to get signed if you're working class anymore, and it's very difficult to become a writer if you're working class anymore. But going online and doing stuff on YouTube and blogging and stuff is one of the few places that kids from any background can go on and find an audience, and it's that gold rush, the same gold rush that there was then culturally. Now it's giving people access.
You can actually but just continue and be the Mick Jagger of internet.
No, absolutely. Although the makeup in the makeup room earlier, the makeup ladies were very concerned when they found out what he did. They were like, so you just sit there all day? And he was like, yes. And they were like, you need to get out and have a walk, love. eat your veg. They were very concerned.
They were, yeah. That's we don't know.
It's great, Felix, to have you on the show.
Oh, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much, Felix. 100 times bigger than me on YouTube.
Only?
More. What should one do to get big on YouTube?
Okay, I have one good tip is to